Hello yours, welcome again. In this video I am going to explain about last concept, that is Wein bridge. So if you can obtain the expression for frequency, then your task is almost completed. But let me draw the bridge circuit first. R1 in parallel with C1. These two are our unknowns, and here you will get R3, here R2 in series with C2, finally R4. The galvanometer will be present here and the supply is given from these two ends. So let me write the node points A, B, C, D. The expression and derivation is all same. Let me explain the bridge balance condition. So here you can get R1 in parallel with 1 by j omega C1. Now as it is almost last video, I think no need to into R4, no need to explain why, because these type we have already seen many times. So I will directly write the expression R1 into 1 by j omega C1 by R1 plus 1 by j omega C1, which gives rise to R1 by 1 plus j omega R1 C1. You can do this on your own into R4. RHS part will be R3 into R2 plus 1 by j omega C2. If you expand this, you will get R3 R2 plus R3 by j omega C2. Now let me expand this. R1 R4 by 1 plus j omega R1 C1, which is equal to R3 R2 into j omega C2 plus R3 by j omega C2. Now you just cross multiply them, so you will get R1 R4 into j omega C2, which is equal to R3 plus j omega R2 R3 C2 into 1 plus j omega R1 C1. So you can look here it is only imaginary part, so there is no a particular real part here. Now what I am going to do is I am going to equate these imaginary parts, or equate the real part present in this to zero. It is simple, I think. So let us as it is imaginary, what I am going to do is equate real part to zero. So I think equal to zero, I think this is easy to do. So R3 into 1, you'll get R3 plus j omega into j omega, j into j, j square, so it is minus 1 into omega square into R2 R3 C2 into R1 C1, which is equal to 0. Now as it is minus this side, you can send this, so you'll get send to right hand side part, you'll get plus. So R3 equal to omega square R2 R3 C2 R1 C1. You can cancel out this R3. So from this, omega equal to 1 by square is there. So root R1 R2 C1 C2. So finally, you are here with the expression for frequency. Similarly, you can solve for imaginary part, but that is not required. Our aim is to find the frequency of operation using Wein bridge. There are different explanations that are possible, that you can take an op amp and you can design the same oscillator, Wein bridge oscillator. We often use these oscillator circuits with capacitor like this. You can solve many, there are many circuits possible to design these Wein bridge oscillators, and the ultimate aim of this is to derive an expression for the frequency of operation. So the thing is, if you can tune C1 and C2, see here you can see C1 and C2 you can tune, or unknown frequency C1 also can be calculated if you know the frequency of operation. For example, you are operating at a particular frequency, then this unknown capacitance can be derived from that. Or to change the frequency, it is enough to change the components. So tuning of the circuit can be done so that different frequency of operations is also possible. But there are still many applications and more broader explanations that are possible. But as per this instrumentation subject, writing up to here or calculating the expression for frequency is more than enough, and this explanation is quite sufficient for Wein bridge for calculation of unknown capacitance. So with this, we can conclude this playlist of electronic measurement and instrumentation. Why? Because we have covered all the bridges that we have discussed in the first video, that is contents, all the two bridges for calculation of resistance and two bridges which in detail derived into again two types. So all these three are covered in calculation of inductance and two covered in calculation of capacitance. So with these seven videos, you can completely attend any question that can come in this bridges concepts. So the problems also will be same. Instead of these unknowns, they might give the direct values, but my suggestion is to solve the question with these unknown values so that you can get the generalized expression for the required unknown values that you have to find, and then you can substitute these values and get the final result. Hope you guys learned something new through this playlist. Please share to your friends, it might help them. If not, please support me. And if you have any doubts regarding these, you can ping me in the comment section. I will happily reply to your comments. That's all for this video. See you in the next one.